Yesterday, embattled Republican Congressman George Santos issued a very weird and cryptic message to reporters who asked him about resigning. When he was asked to his face, like, hey, are you going to resign? George Santos said this: if 142 people ask for me to resign, I'll resign. He said that while he was exiting his office. He said that to CNN's Kristen Wilson. 142 people. That's all I need. You'll get 142 people to ask me to resign and I'll resign. He didn't say 142 members of Congress. He just said 142 people. Okay, well, I've seen already a lot of people on Twitter call for that. I'll add it. George Santos, resign. So, you know, however many that makes now, I'm sure we could get 142 people watching this to also say George Santos should resign. But what baffled the reporters is, why that number? Because 142 doesn't mean anything. It's not even, okay, here's the thing. Two-thirds of the House GOP conference is 148. So if he wanted two-thirds of Republicans in Congress to ask him to resign, he was off by six. So is that maybe what he meant? Nobody knows. Everybody's a little confused. Fox News suggested that, okay, well, he won by 142,000 votes. So maybe the 142 is because he got 142,000 votes, and maybe one person represents each thousand. Who knows? But nobody knows. But the bottom line is, we've already seen, you know, from social media, 142 people asked George Santos to resign. I don't think that he's actually keeping track, because if he were, he'd have to abide by his own statement and resign. But he wouldn't do that. 5 million people could come. 142 million could come out and tell him to resign, and he's not going to resign. He has made that clear. The worst part, of course, is that he now has the backing to not resign by House Speaker Kevin McCarthy. McCarthy was asked on Wednesday of this week, like, are you going to ask him to resign? And McCarthy's like, yeah, that's what elections are for. Those people get to decide. And they sent him to office. They sent a fraud to office. They sent something that didn't exist to office. Like, you can't say that, nope, the voters decided. The voters decided and voted for a person that George Santos was pretending to be. But all these calls for resignation, again, they're moot. He's not going to do it. It doesn't matter how many people come out, if he gets 142 or if he gets 10 times more than that. He's not going to resign. So all we can do is, one, hope that the voters in that district don't make the same mistake 2 years from now. But more importantly, let's hope that those campaign finance violations, which apparently keep adding up for Santos, are enough to get him prosecuted, which would then basically force the Republicans to expel him from Congress. Or better yet, let's hope he ends up in a Brazilian prison in the next couple months. Because at that point, I'm pretty sure the Republicans really would have no choice but to get rid of him.
I know what a lot of you out there are thinking. You're thinking, wouldn't it be amazing if you could wear the Ring of Fire logo across your chest? Well, now you can. Just head on over to our Teespring page to find some awesome merch we're offering for our viewers. We have more designs that are going to be added in the near future, so just follow the link in the description or take a peek at the shelf of merchandise under this video. Thanks for watching.